Hi, I'm Rachel Bailey Marshall from Diamond Valley, Eureka County, Nevada. I grew up in this county. I've lived here most of my life as a farmer and a rancher. I went to school in Reno after high school from here. Ranching is my main interest. Ranchers don't retire. They just continue on. Well, we used to raise cows, but we don't anymore. We just have mixed hay, which usually is shipped as far as South Carolina. They like our high altitude hay, and it sells for a good price, which is nice. I had a wonderful childhood, parents that were the greatest. We rode to school by horseback for the first 3 years of our school life, and then they moved the school near to our house because we were the only ones then attending school. There was a corral. My dad had made a little corral where we could leave the horses, and so they had a good place. But then when I was in about the third grade, they moved the school close to our house because there was no other kids in the valley. We were the only ones. So they moved the school for us, and we just were able to walk to school then. I know during my early grades, it was during the war, and the teachers were very difficult to find. You couldn't find a teacher. So my mother talked her sister into coming from Reno to teach us because they couldn't find a teacher. She was a wonderful person, a great Christian, and she was a real influence on us. She didn't really want to come and teach us, but my mother talked her into it because she couldn't find any other teachers. She actually lived in Sparks, and she loved Sparks, but she did come and taught for 2 years. And then we went into high school in Eureka, and that was more difficult because there were no buses in those days, and my mother had to take us every day to school, which was really rather difficult because it was 30 miles. Well, yes, this is Mrs. John Esquaga now.
And what was her name as a little girl?
Rosie Ardanz. Besides high school, then I went to the University of Nevada, graduated with what they called a normal certificate in those days. For teaching. Mm-hmm. I always wanted to be a teacher, I'm not sure. I never really thought of doing anything else. My last year I taught was in Henderson, and I had 44 kids in my class. That was a difficult class. I think I just enjoyed the kids, and I really enjoyed just regular lessons more than fun things, I think. To me, teaching was a serious thing. I am a strong believer in education. I believe every child should have as much education as possible. And I think it's for the good of not only for individuals, but it's good for the country. It's good for everybody to be well educated. I'm a strong believer in education. It gives them not only livelihood, but it gives them self-confidence and they earn a great deal of respect for themselves. She definitely was an influence. She was a marvelous mother. No one could have been a better mother, I don't think. She was fun. She was understanding. She was very smart. She understood politics and things like that, as well as taking care of her family. That as a baby, she didn't like her picture taken, so you're not going to find very many pictures of her. She did not believe in having a picture taken. She understood politics very well, and she was a leader. She formed the Farm Bureau, for the county, the Eureka County Farm Bureau. She formed that, and. We had a very nice group in those years, and they did a lot of getting together and doing local things, which was very nice. She was responsible for bringing a Quonset hut in to the valley because we had no place to get together for social gatherings or meetings or anything. And so she had that brought in, and it was used in my early years. We always enjoyed the dances and the meetings and the suppers that we would have there. And it was a way to get together. She believed that the people should get together. They needed to have to be together. It's a community feeling, you know. My mother ran for commissioner. She was the first lady commissioner in the county. And she really enjoyed her work. She enjoyed politics. And I think she did a good job. I'm sure she did. I think she had a good backing. There was one gentleman that ran against her, but he was rather sort of far out in his thinking, and I don't think he had a chance against my mother. She did not like any publicity. She didn't want, you know, the spotlight on her at all. She did what she did on her own, but she was very conscious of all the problems in the county, and she worked hard for them. I grew up, of course, on a cattle ranch. Then later in life, when I married, my husband was a young man that had come from California to one of our neighboring ranches to work for the man that bought that ranch from an old couple that had lived there many years. And they bought the ranch, and he took it over and to run it, and and we were married then and lived on that ranch, and then the owners sold it, so that meant that we were out of a job, and so we did a lot of moving about around the state, and my husband did construction work. So we did a lot of moving around the state at that time, and then ended up in California. And we lived there for about 15 years in Central California, where two of our children were born there. We lived there for a while, and he did a lot of construction work there. Then we came back to Diamond Valley and bought the farm that we have now to raise alfalfa. And then later we changed it to mixed grass. And this was a farm rather than a ranch. Where I was raised was on a ranch, a cattle ranch. And where I first lived as a married person was on a cattle ranch too. But this now is a farm. So I've been both rancher and farmer. Mostly we raised alfalfa. But then if you raise alfalfa a number of years, you have to rotate. So we went into the mixed grass. And this has a very good sale in the eastern part of the country. So most of our grass now is baled and then taken into the Carolinas for horse feed. This is a high elevation here, and it makes a difference in the protein and in the nutrition in the high elevation grass, and also alfalfa is very desirable and very easy to market because they like it. It's much better nutrition than that raised at low elevation. Well, I think the driving force in my life probably is Christ-based, but definitely to do with education. I'm a firm believer in that. And I enjoyed my years of teaching, and I enjoy having my grandchildren being educated now. I think it's a very important thing. This was in Henderson, Nevada, the last year of my teaching. It was a fourth grade. I had 44 children in that class. It was very difficult. They didn't have much money at Henderson in those days, and so rather than having an extra teacher, they had to put a lot of children in each room, and it was difficult, but they were all good kids, and I enjoyed them. Well, I think the advice that I would give to young people today is always that their life should be Christ-based. They need Christ in their life and go from there in whichever direction they are led. But I'm also very much in favor of a very good education. And I think that that is what our nation needs in this day. I believe in children being very busy and having something to do. I think that's why it's such a blessing for kids to be raised on a ranch or a farm where they're always busy. And I think that we have some very fine young people from this area.